Happy Sunday, huh? Good to be here. What a nice, perfect night. We had to pay extra for this. I didn't know that. Welcome to the Mainstay. It is great to see you here. Very busy time of year for us. We're thrilled that we're finally able to have a few nights where we can use this wonderful outdoor stage. And when our friends, the Stars, come out later on, it's really an exceptional evening. Well, I have to tell you, I'll tell you a bunch of stuff later about what's coming up, but we have some wonderful things coming up in just the next few weeks. Little blues, little bluegrass, little soul music, things that I'm really looking forward to, and I think you'll enjoy it too. So, I wanted to tell you that after being here for nearly 2 years, I realized that my education is lacking in three areas. It's one in dogs. How many of you people have dogs? See what I mean? I don't have a dog, right? And the other is oysters. We got feedback here. Oysters, I don't do the oyster thing. Yeah. Okay, and the other was boats, and I went on one of my very first sailboat rides last week, and had a good time. But I thought I should do something about the dogs thing. So I went to a news channel, and I looked up a dog show, a competition. And I watched it for a while, and the judges were looking at all these wonderful creatures, and at the end they awarded three prizes, and one was to a Yorkie, and one was to a Jack Russell, and the other one was to a Skye. But after a while, it seemed like all the judges had ulterior motives. No rim shots for them? I don't know. Okay. But tonight we're gonna find out. As Frank Zappa said, most people wouldn't know good music if it came up and bit them on the ass. But that's not going to happen tonight. You're in treats for one of the best rock and roll bands I've heard in a while. So let's welcome the Blake Thompson Band.
Thank you. How you doing tonight, everybody? It's great to see you. Thank you very much. Frank Zappa actually said a lot of things. I remember as a little boy, being about 10 years old, when my stepbrother, Sammy Cox, got his first stack of Columbia House records, 13 for a penny. And one of them was a Frank Zappa album, that there's nothing on that album that you can play live in front of decent people. So yeah, that was a real eye-opener for this 10-year-old. Anyway, speaking of 10-year-olds, we got our little 10-year-old Rachel. She's going to get up and sing later with us. I'm happy to be here. It's my wife, Kate, everybody. Kate Russo. It's my daughter, Sarah. My acoustic guitar. We got the whole family here. It's my son, Blake, Jr., keyboards. We got Josie Pearl, our daughter, on bass guitar. We got our good friend, Russ Roniker, on drums, everybody.
And I are no different. Talk about the old times, then we'll all go fishing. In Avalon, you're never tired, but you can sleep whenever you want. Traffic and rainy days, and maybe I'll meet you in Avalon. Thank you.
Ladies and gents, I want to introduce Sarah on the vocals right now. We're going to take you way back to when you were real young.
Yeah, this one too.
Hey Clark, mute her vocal. I'm gonna switch mics just to see if that's what it is. This one can come down. This has gotten turned up really loud. Hey, hey, 1, 2. Bring that down here. 1, 2. Hey, hey. 1, 2. Down a little more. Hey, hey. Is that the right one? 1, 2. Hey, hey. Hey, hey. Hey, hey. Hey, hey. That, that's not. Two.
1, 2, yeah. 1, 2.
Hey, 1, 2. Yeah, this one needs to come up. Strange.
Can you give her your mic? I don't want to let her sing this one next time.
It's fine.
Singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to arise. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Into the light of a dark black night. blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to arise. You were only waiting for this moment to arise. You were only waiting for this moment to
Mr. Thompson, I
special is the music that you bring. Well, it makes me sing. Now all I can do is think of you and wonder, oh, how you're playing right with, and if you have been rocked yet. Mr. Thompson, are you there? Did you go to California, Miami, or somewhere down in Mexico again? Mr. Thompson, when will you get home? Mr. Thompson, yeah.
Here we go.
I can't wait till you get home, Mr. Thompson. Well, I can't wait till you get home, Mr. Thompson. Oh, I can't wait till you get home, Mr. Thompson. Oh, I can't wait till you get home, Mr. Thompson. Oh, Mr. Thompson. Mr. Thompson. Mr. Thompson. Thank you. That's a true story.
Thanks 17, Sarah's 14, Josie's 12, Russ is 21, and she's 29.
52 and proud, baby! Still standing after all these years!
This is a tune that Kate and I did in a band of ours called The Elliots. And we, in fact, played here at the Mainstay in 2003, if I'm not mistaken. It's been a long time.
That was pre These Children, by the way.
Yes. We lived in Tempe, Arizona for several years. It was a wonderful place.
Arizona in the house. Yeah, right on.
We used to call Tucson Tattoo-son. Everybody had tattoos. I used to have a great friend of mine I played with out there. He was from Northern Michigan. And he used to say, "We tune because we care." Actually, we tune because we have these really easy to use tuners now that they didn't have 50 years ago. I remember seeing a little photograph of Paul McCartney trying to tune his bass backstage at Shea Stadium with John Lennon giving him a harmonica note.
Greatest. So in the olden days, when I didn't have children and my only life was music, I don't know, that's like two or three lifetimes ago. Anyway, I used to sit around sometimes and I would just do stuff. Anybody know what that's like? Because I don't remember that now. I'm usually pretty busy now, but back then, I would just be sitting around just doing stuff. And sometimes I'd just sit around and I'd turn on the old TV. You guys remember the olden days when TV didn't have a bunch of channels? Yeah. Even going back to before these kids were born, there weren't 8,000 channels. Well, sometimes I would just flip through the channels, and one day I was flipping through, and I came on some sports channel, and I gotta tell you, you can probably tell from looking at me, sports is not my thing. But I will say, I watched these kids, they were doing a skateboard competition. So I stopped, and I looked, I thought, that's really cool. I had a brother, I've got four, and one of them was really into skateboards and doing tricks. And so anyway, I'm watching these kids doing these crazy tricks and I'm thinking, man, this is unbelievable. And they actually had an announcer, and the announcer was talking about what the kids were doing. So then all of a sudden, the guy says, oh no, he's caught between a Smith and a lip slide. I thought, I'm not sure what that means, but I love the way it sounds. So I grabbed a pen, I grabbed my little pad, my notebook pad that I used to write my lyrics in, and I jotted that down. I said, that just sounds like something I should use in a song. And so that led me to this song, which is called Rock and Landslide. And you will hear it. It says, caught between a Smith and a lipslide. And now you know why it says that, which is probably more than most people ever know about this song.
Thank you. don't know what happened to this voice, but it all but went out of this monitor. So if you could turn it up a little bit, I kept trying to reach you. Just help me out a little with that one. One, two. Yeah. One, two. Yeah. One, two. Say something.
One, two.
We're talking about mix.
Two?
Mix two?
No. That's mix one.
All right, mix one. One, two. One, two. Using the force. One, two. Yeah. Okay. Yep. Thank you.
Okay, we're going to bring up a young lady right now. Her name is Rachel, and she's going to sing a song by Dolly Parton. Bring this down in the monitors. Bring it down in the monitors. Hey, hey, hey. Choose to be.
fly me to the moon, or let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on a Jupiter and Mars.
Thank you.
Wasn't that young woman amazing? Wow. And what a perfect night. Everything has been so nice about this night. People have been complimentary. One woman came up to me and said, I noticed that you wear black a lot. And I said, oh, yeah. Like, well, she said, oh, it looks nice on you. The next woman came up and said, you know, you like you have all this black on, but you've got all this white on your back. And then she started spanking me. And the reason why I bring that up is that if any of you happen to go to the grocery store just before coming here and happen to buy a bag of flour, come and see me. Thank you. No room shots again. Never when you need them. So very briefly, before we bring the musicians back up, I want to tell you about our next scheduled efforts. Next weekend, we get a break, but the town of Rock Hall will be full of pirates and wenches. Is that next weekend? No, I'm sorry. We have something before then. Next Friday night, our resident impresario, Joe Holt, is doing his first Friday program, and his special guest is Sylvia Frazier. Many of you might already know Sylvia. Sylvia is a member of the Chestertown community and the leader and perhaps the founder of the 100 Voice Choir. But she's going to do an evening of the Ladies of Soul music. And she's going to do Aretha and Gladys Knight and maybe throw in a little Mahalia Jackson. And Joe's very excited about it, and I think it's going to be a great program. That's Friday the 4th. The following weekend, this place is going to be full of one-eyed pirates and buxom wenches. And everybody's going to be walking around for 2.5 days saying arg and having a few drinks, perhaps. But there's also stuff for the kids to do. It's kind of evolved into a family thing, treasure hunts and such. So that's Friday, Saturday, and Sunday of the weekend of the 11th, 12th, 13th, I believe. After that, about a year ago, we took a survey of our mailing list, and we asked people, what kind of music would you like to see more of? And the overwhelming and somewhat surprising response was the blues. People wanted to hear more blues. We've got a great group coming, led by a man named Mikey Jr. And Mikey Jr. is the classic harp player. He plays not only a blues harp, but he also plays the chromatic harp. The chromatic harp is the harp that you can play like a piano because it has all the notes on it, not just chords. And he's amazing. He's got this young vitality. The Mikey Jr. Blues Band, that's on Saturday the 19th. And then on the next weekend, on Friday the 20th, help me out with this, folks. 19th, 7th, the 25th. Is a newgrass or a bluegrass group with an edge, and that's the Barefoot Movement. And I've listened to their music. They're really wonderful. And some of those will be outside, weather permitting. So if you've enjoyed yourself tonight, and as we get, of course, on those Saturday, Friday, and Saturday nights, we start out a little later so we get to enjoy more starlight. But thank you again for all coming tonight. In response to the Blake Thompson Band, let's bring the Blake Thompson Band back.
Sorry.
we're going to give Sarah another chance because she wasn't really heard before, so we just really want her to be heard.
That is Sarah. She is 14. And that song was actually my request, because I've loved that song forever, since the first time I heard it. And I was really happy to finally actually get to play it live, because I really couldn't sing it myself, you know. So anyway, back here on the bass guitar is our Josie. Pearl Josephine, we call her Josie. And she is 12 years old. And I gotta say, a lot of what we do is baptism by fire. And Russ, the drummer, can tell you that, because I have thrown things at him. I've written up full sets, sent them out to the band, and we get to the show and I go, yeah, I'm not doing any of that. You know, and so I have thrown stuff at my kids And we have been so blessed because they've grabbed it and ran with it. And they worked with it on their own. We didn't really have to browbeat them to do it, thankfully.
And not much.
But we've had some fun sessions because anybody knows that when you work with your family, it can be tough. And but you have wonderful things that come out of it. And I'm so happy to have a band. I watched the Partridge Family when I was a little kid. I don't know if anybody else did. But I thought that was awesome. And that was even before I started playing guitar. So anyway, just a big shout out to Josie on the bass. This is Blake Jr. He's 17 years old on the piano. He also plays drums with us when we're not down here, because when we're down here, Russ plays with us all the time. And Blakey does, up north, we do a full Janis Joplin tribute. It's called Piece of My Pearl. My wife actually toured with the band Big Brother and the Holding Company for many, many years. And so she's got some wonderful stories to tell about that. And we'll get to that a little later in this set. And right now, Blake plays drums in our Janis tribute called Piece of My Pearl, but we put him on keyboards and he's just taken off on piano.
He's awesome.
On the south side of Chicago is the baddest part of town. And if you go down there, you better just beware of a man named Leroy Brown. Well, Leroy, more trouble. See, he stands about 6'4". All the downtown ladies call him treetop lover. All the men just call him sir. And he's bad, bad, Leroy Brown. Baddest man in the whole damn town. Badder than a old King Kong. Meaner than a junkyard dog. Well, Leroy, he's a gambler. And he likes his fancy clothes. And he likes to wear his diamond rings in front of everybody's nose. He's got a custom. Eldorado too. He's got a 32 gun in his pocket for fun. He's got a razor in his shoe. And he's bad, bad, a Leroy Brown. A baddest man in the whole damn town. Battling old King Cowan. A meaner than a junkyard dog. Well, Friday, about a week ago, Leroy's shooting dice. And at the end of the bar sat a girl named Dolores. And ooh, that girl looked nice. Well, he cast his eyes upon her. And the trouble soon began. Leroy Brown learned his lesson about messing with the wife of a jealous man. And he's bad, bad, Leroy Brown. Well, the two men took to fighting, and when they pulled them from the floor, Leroy looked like a jigsaw puzzle with a couple of pieces gone. And he's bad, bad, Leroy Brown, the baddest man in the whole damn town. Badder than old King Kong. Meaner than a junkyard dog. And he's bad, bad, Leroy Brown. The baddest man in the whole downtown. Battling old King Cowan. Meaner than a junkyard dog. I said battling old King Cowan. Meaner than a junkyard dog.
The first time I ever heard that song, I was with my grandmother, Margaret Sharber, and her and my grandfather used to go see Dave Brandt out at Great Oak. Does anybody remember Dave Brandt? Come on now. Dave Brand. Brand, that's right. All I remembered was the gold rings and the gold chains and whatnot. Man, he played organ, which I thought was super cool. But we were happy to do that song. That's what it reminds me of.
Right, so way back in the, I don't know, early to mid-90s, I'd say probably around 1994, one day I was in Woodstock, New York, and I had read a book by my now friend, Elliot Landy, who's a great photographer, and I was trying to learn about all of these great classic rock stars, and one of the great classic rock stars I read about was a band called The Band. Anybody ever hear of The Band? Okay, so I'm living in Woodstock. At this time, Woodstock's actually still all artists and musicians. So my band's there, and we're doing our thing, and at the time, we had a lot of really good success. God was very good to us. Well, I looked at the pictures in the books, and I was trying to figure out some of these players, and we went to a gas station to gas up on our car, which is a little Subaru hatchback, and I look over on the other side, and there's this man, and I think to myself, I feel like I recognize that guy from one of the pictures. So I say to my guitarist, man, I think that looks like Rick Danko, but he's kind of like older and heavier. I was young back then, okay? I said, I think I read he has a brother named Terry, so maybe that's him. My guitarist was much bolder than I. I was probably about 23 at the time. So he looks over and he says to him, Terry Danko? So the man sticks out his hand, he goes, no, I'm Rick, that's my brother, how you doing? So we met Rick Danko, who was just a phenomenal bass player and a great singer in the band, and he came over to our house, and we hung out for the rest of the day talking, and we got to share a lot of really fun times. He was just a wonderful inspiration, and he said to me, you know, if I was younger, I could really help you guys, but at this point in our career, we're much older. It's the 1990s, everything's different in the music business. So I tell you what, I'll bring you out to all my shows and you get up and play with me. I'll pay you as much as I can, but I'll do anything I can to try to help you. So I had the pleasure and the honor of going and playing with him in New York City several times in Woodstock. And we were actually real life friends because we both played in a band called Ronnie Hawkins and the Hawks. So I got the chance to play on, you guys might have heard of a show, it's, I don't know if it's even still on, it's called Conan O'Brien. Anybody know that show? That was my introduction to real TV, and I played on a lot of news type things, but I got a chance to be on Conan O'Brien with Ronnie Hawkins and the Hawks, and Rick came and played with us, and his brother Terry was a member of the Hawks, so I had an opportunity to get to know him very well. We're still very good friends today. Of course, Rick passed away some time ago, but whenever I got up to play with Rick, he was so gracious, he was so kind, he made everybody feel like they were a long-lost friend. And it's just a special gift he had as a human being to make everybody feel loved and appreciated. And let me tell you, folks, I've met a couple of, probably several big names in the music business, and there really aren't very many like Rick. Rick made you feel important, and it didn't matter who you were. So when I got a chance to go and sing and play with him, it was so incredible, and he would bring me up, and we'd play with all kinds of great people. But every time we did, it was always really fun. He was so kind, he was so generous, and he is a soul that I look forward to hopefully seeing one day in heaven. But whenever I'd sing with him, I'm going to tell you, the highlight of my time performing with him was that on the records, he sang a really high part, and when we played live, I'd get to sing his high part. So I'd be playing with him, singing his part. I'm not gonna lie, folks, that was a natural high, unlike any other. So we're gonna do a little song right now for you by the band, and I wanna dedicate this one to Rick.
I pulled in Nazareth, I was feeling about half past dead. I
just need some place that I can lay my head. I said, can you tell me where a man might find a bed? He just grinned, shook my hand, and that was all he said. I went looking for a place to hide. When I saw Carmen and the devil walking side by side, I said, hey Carmen, come on, let's go uptown. I said, I got to go, but my friend can't stick around. Take a load off, Mary. You put the load right on me. I'll go down, Miss Moses. Well, there's nothing that you can say. But it's just old Luke, and Luke's waiting on the judgment day. Well, Luke, my friend, what about young Anna Lee? Do me a favor, boy, won't you stay and keep Emily company? Take a load off, Emily. Take a load for free. Take a load off, Emily. And you put the load on.
Load all in. And you
put the load, put the load right on me. A shiver in the dark, it's raining in the park. In the meantime, south of the river, you stop and you hold everything. Man is blowing Dixie double full time. Well, you step inside and you don't see too many faces. Coming in out of the rain, you hear the jazz go down. Competition from other faces. And the horns, they blow on that sound. Way on down south. Way on down south in London town. Check out Guitar George. He knows all the chords. It's strictly rhythm. He doesn't want to make it cry or sing. They say an old guitar is all he can afford. He gets up under the lights to do his thing. And Russell doesn't mind if he doesn't make the scene. He's got a daytime job, he's doing all right. He can play the honky-tonk like anything. Saving it up for Friday night. With the Sultans. With the Sultans of Swing. Thank you.
and a crowd of young boys fooling around in the corner, just in the rhythm, and you know, in the platform souls. They don't give a damn about any trumpet playing band. It ain't what they call rock and roll. With the Sultans. Yeah, the Sultans play Creole. Creole, baby. And the man, he steps right up to the microphone. In that, oh yeah, you hear the rail go down. Well, good night, say it's time to go home. He gets up on the lights to do his thing. With the Sultans. With the Sultans of Sweden. Thank you. guys, we have run a little late, so we got time to do one more for you, or maybe two. Right now, we're going to turn this over to this girl to my right, Kate Russo. I met Kate Russo in Tempe, Arizona. Technically in Mesa, Arizona, I believe, but I can't remember. No, it was in Tempe. She was on tour. It was at a big club called the Bash on Ash.
I remember.
And she was on tour, and I was doing sound. I had the same job that Clark has back there tonight. Everybody, a big hand for Clark on sound. And so I was doing that gig. I saw this girl come in with another band, and she killed it. She played all kinds of instruments, as you can see, and I thought, what? And then she picked up the violin and proceeded to play this rock, blues, insane stuff on the violin. Many of you have seen her. You know what I'm talking about. Right? I thought it was Stevie Ray Vaughan reincarnated on the fiddle. So, anywho, we became fast friends, and we were friends for quite a while, and then we became one, and we've never been apart since. And then these kids showed up. You know, they were like clockwork, and it was awesome, and now we got a family band, and it's a wonderful thing. But I'm gonna let Kate talk to you about this next song, about this band.
I wasn't sure what he was leading up to here. That's the great thing about marriage. You just never gonna get, right? Oh, hold on.
Don't touch. You know what? First, let's do Sky's Cry. Tell them about that. So we're gonna maybe do a couple more songs. Hopefully they won't call us on the sound ordinance. But we're gonna do a short one of this.
We'll do a short one, okay. All right, so when I first started getting my feet wet in the real world of professional music, I was about 20 years old. Somebody found me. They heard my name was Kate, and they didn't know my last name. And it was a guitarist named Jonathan. And Jonathan called every single Kate in the New England Conservatory book of people that were going to the school at the time, till he found me. He had heard about me from a couple different people in his band. He heard about a girl that was playing Jimi Hendrix on the violin. At the time, I just had a regular violin. I was just a regular violin student at a music school. And then another member of his band did a gig with me, and I was playing Eric Clapton, and I was playing Layla on piano. And so the two people had talked to him about this girl named Kate. So when they had an opportunity and they needed a violinist, he called every name in the directory until he found me. And I told him, hey, you know, no offense, but I've got a scholarship to go to school, and I'm not really looking for a job. He said, I'm sorry, I won't take no for an answer. I thought, okay, this is trouble for me. So I met with him, and he had a very, very good group, and they played all over. They had a National Endowment for the Arts grant to go play out in Iowa, and it was kind of a big deal because it was like a $50,000 grant. And they gave us an apartment and a house and all of our gigs and all of our meals and all of our transportation. And at the time, all my university professors at the conservatory sort of said, you know, that's the gig you want to get. So go do it. So when I went on the road, I had been struck by a certain song that I heard when I was driving one day. It was a song by Stevie Ray Vaughan. You guys like Stevie Ray? I'd never heard of Stevie until I heard this song on the radio, and when I heard it, I was blown away. Well, when I was in Iowa, it was my 21st birthday, and somebody kept playing this song on the jukebox, and I just turned 21 that night, and when I heard it, I just said, you know, just keep playing that song, keep playing that song. And I said, kind of, sometimes people make an impetuous comment. My impetuous comment was, I'm going to learn that song note for note on the violin. And all the people around me just sort of laughed and sort of went, yeah, okay, whatever. It's like a guitar song, so good luck. Anyway, from that day forward, this song sort of became my calling card. And this song is called The Sky Is Crying. And thanks for bearing with that very, very long story. It sort of changed my world on violin. At that point, I started playing with some distortion, and I really started spreading my wings in terms of what I wanted to do on the violin, because there are I don't know, pretty much most of the world of violinists that are better than me. So I just decided I would try to find something to make my own little place, and this was part of it. The sky is crying. Can't you see the tears roll down the street? The sky is crying. Can't you see the tears roll down the street? Thank you. Janis Joplin's band, Big Brother and the Holding Company. I got an opportunity to go up on stage with them at Manny's Car Wash in New York City. They said, okay, let's hear that Sky's Crying Girl on the violin. And then they hired me. So they hired me to come sing with them in Mexico City. And then after that, they said, hey, listen, why don't you come and play some of that crazy violin and just do whatever you want. So if you want to play violin, great. If you want to sing, great. If you want to play keyboards, great. Whatever you want to do. So I've had a blessed life, thanks to God. I've got an opportunity to do so much. And I just want to thank each and every one of you for being here with us tonight, the Thompson family and the Blake Thompson band. Thank y'all. We're going to say goodnight with this one, I think. This is a little Janis Joplin, so if you know it, join me, won't you? Busted flag in Baton Rouge, waiting for a train, when I was faded near, as faded as my jeans. You know it! Bob had thumbed the diesel down, just before it rained, and rode us all the way into New Orleans. Yeah, I pulled my violin out of my dirty red bandana. I was playing songs while Bobby sang the blues. Yeah. The windshield wipers left me 10 miles, holding Bobby's head alive. Oh, we sang ever a song that drove the new. All freedom is just another word for nothing left to lose. Oh, again, I'm feeling your most easy now when it sang blues. Well, feeling good was good enough for me. Oh, good enough for me and my body ever again.
Sing it out, people. La-di-da-da-da, yeah, Bobby, I'm a guy.